Yes, guys, and we're back. FIFA 19, brand new career mode. Bournemouth, we've gone with them. Can we do it? Can we get into the Champions League in our first season? That's what the target is. It's quite a big target, but looking at the squad, I think it could be possible. So, first things first, transfers. As we can see, I brought in three players in the first window. Spent the big money on Loftus-Cheek. Felt like we needed another strong centre mid. Walker Peters was for the future, and Ampudu, just because he's a young player with a bit of potential to grow. We did have a lot of transfers going out, shifting a lot of deadwood, just to try and raise some funds as well. We haven't got to get into each and every one of them. So, let's just get into the first game, straight away, Cardiff at home. So yeah, as we mentioned, the target for this first season is getting into the Champions League. The board expect us to finish mid-table, but I think we can do a bit more than that. This first game was my first game in Ultimate, and I'm not going to lie, it's difficult. It's a lot more difficult than Legendary is. As we can see, the first chance falls to Fraser. He should have put that away. And then Cardiff break through, and their first shot goes in. Now, if you look at the replay, Begovic, I don't know what he's doing. He gets a hand on it, and it just is completely useless. As the game went on, we were having more and more chances. We were getting closer. We were all over them. We just couldn't find that way through. And then, in the 77th minute, ball goes that wide to Defoe. He cuts it back. Gives it to Josh King on the edge of the box. And then Finesse, beautifully, picks up a brilliant goal. He's going to be a big player for us this season. The crowd love it. So, that brought up full time for our first game. We got a point. Wasn't a loss, but we need to be doing better than that. Up next, we had a long trip to West Ham away, going to the Olympic Stadium. I expected a much harder game for this one. First 10 minutes, they didn't even touch the ball. Ball comes out to Jordan Ibe. He's out wide. What can he do? Sees Lerma on the edge of the box, drills it in. Absolutely quality finish. Definitely brought our finishing boots today. So now we can see Ibe, he's got so much space. He absolutely crucified Zabaleta this game. He was nowhere near him. Brings it back, and then who's there? Josh King. Once again, quality finish. And what's that? Jordan Ibe again. Breaking through. He's got pace for days. Cuts it back. Wilson. Tapping. Half an hour gone. We're 3-0 up. Could be game over already. Are we done there? We're not done there. Jordan Ibe, once again, drags it back. Stanislas coming off the other wing, drills it in. West Ham are all over the place. 4-0, half-time. Now, I probably could have laid off, but out of nowhere, Winston Reid, moment of madness. I don't know what he was thinking. Gives away a penalty. Up steps King, our main man. Can he get a third of the season already? Yes, he can. Now, unfortunately, they did come back. It was a bit sloppy. Silly goal to give away. Wanted a clean sheet. Coming into the closing stages of the game, ball gets whipped in, falls to Lewis Cook on the edge of the box. Very weird finish. But that makes it 6. It definitely makes up for the chances we didn't put away in the Cardiff game. Very happy with this. Absolutely fantastic response. So up next we had Everton at home. After hitting 6, spirits were high. We were looking to build from that. Now Everton shouldn't have been a difficult game, but in the opening 25 minutes, Theo Walcott, somehow, he scores a header. I mean, it's such poor defending, like, somebody like him should not be scoring a header at the back post. Really disappointed to give away that goal. Now, to be honest, this game was really difficult. Chances were so limited, they were defending so well. 75th minute even, ball comes to Loftus-Cheek, and somehow, it's agonisingly close. The whole game, we just spent pretty much chasing the ball. We didn't really have many chances, and we picked up our first loss of the season. So a win, a draw, and a loss in our opening 3 games. Up next, we were playing one of the big boys. We're away at Chelsea. We needed a big performance here. We need to see how we cope with the better teams. Now, I'm not going to lie, I would happily settled for a point before this game started, but as it went on, the counter-attacking strategy, just trying to hit them quickly on the break, it seemed to be paying off quite early on. 10 minutes in, Jordan Ibe, he's got loads of room. All he's got to do is finish it. Keeper saves it. But then Stanislas is there for a tap-in. Straight away, they did come close to equalising. Willian sneaking in, hitting the post. And then something that's probably going to happen quite a lot this season, giving the ball away at the back. And then Willian, special moment there. Very good finish. Keeper was never saving that. 32 minutes into the game. Once again, you can see the counter is playing absolutely beautifully. Jordan Ibe, once again, finds himself in loads of space. Can he pick someone out? Wilson, easy goal. Now, we're just coming up to half-time. I wanted to see it out, see if we can go in with morale high, being 2-1 up away at Chelsea. But then the little Belgium Hazard, I mean, that is a rocket. No keeper is saving that. I should have probably fouled him, but, I mean, the strike was unbelievable. So very annoyingly, we go in level at half-time. In the second half, we were probably looking at trying to hit him on the counter again. Ball comes out to Wilson. We've got time, we've got space, but the players were looking quite tired. Josh King picks up the ball down the wing. There's no one in the box. Nothing's really on. Trying to recycle possession now. Loftus-Cheek gives it to Lerma. He's an absolute rock. Stanislas finds King. Jordan Ibe's in a bit of space. What can he do? Top corner. Beautiful finish. We're back in the lead. A few moments later, we had another chance, but Chelsea pick it up quite easily. Now, we're stuck in two minds from this point, whether or not to push for a fourth and try and get that gap, or just try and defend. But as I've mentioned previously in other videos, I really can't defend. I mean, I didn't know whether to press them. I didn't know whether to stand off. I mean, they make it look so easy the way they build up the pitch. Really putting the pressure on. Playing it around my players as if they're not even there. Now, I probably should have fouled Willian. He absolutely skinned Charlie Daniels. Whips in the cross, and then how about that for a finish? They equalise for a third time. Really annoyingly. But I mean, what a goal that is. That could be goal of the season already. Coming into the closing stages of the game, I started pushing forwards again. We're trying to do what we do best, going forwards. Gives it to Stanislas. He has a pop. Goalie saves it. It's probably quite comfortable, really. 85th minute, they were really piling the pressure on. We were just hanging in there, and all we could try and do was hope. Hope we get one lucky break. Stanislas, he's finding room, but he's absolutely shattered. Picks out Lewis Cook, and then he drags it wide. That level of quality needs to improve. On the scheme of things, a point at Stamford Bridge is not a bad result. We will happily take that. So up next on our list, we had Leicester at home. Now, we needed to start picking up points at home because for some reason, we just played as an entirely different team. Now, the opening few moments, we just couldn't really get possession going. Kept giving the ball away. They managed to hit us on the break. Iheanacho finds Maddison, and then they take an early lead 7 minutes in. It's not how you want to start a game. As they were growing into the game, Damari Gray was absolutely killing me down the wing. They had another early chance. Corner comes in, and then this happens. I mean, how is that a penalty? Regardless, Iheanacho steps up, sends Begovic the wrong way. We're 2-0 down inside 15 minutes, all over the place. We needed something, some kind of route back into this game. King gets through, and then Kasper Schmeichel absolutely flattens him. Gives away a penalty. He steps up, and then he saves it. I mean, justice wasn't served there. He should have been sent off, surely. Going into the second half, we were really desperately trying to get that goal. We just couldn't really find a way through. But then Callum Wilson drills it into the top corner, dragging us back into this game. Approaching the final stages of the game, Josh King was through, but he was absolutely shattered, and he shanks his shot. Really disappointed. Final few minutes of the game, I mean, Leicester just, they pull out an overhead kick out of nowhere. There's no need for that. And that brings up full time. It's another loss. It's not looking good. So, racing through the next few set of games, we had Watford away up next. Quite early on, we gave away a penalty out of nowhere. But Begovic, absolutely fantastic. His moment of the season so far, he saves it. Straight after that, pretty much, we break through, and then King gets an absolutely trademark finish. It's very Thierry Henry-esque, this finish. He opens his body up, puts it in the far corner. Nicely done. I missed another goal somewhere along the way, but 2-0 up, and then this moment of madness happens. They claw one back quite late on, but then Jordan Ayew pops up, 3-1, game over, good night. Those are the points. Happy days. Flying into the next game, we've got Southampton at home. Jordan Ayew doing what he does best, making that run through and getting a finish away. Callum Wilson, tapping. Easy stuff. Southampton never really in the game. He's through again, they bring him down, they give away a penalty. Upsets our main man, Josh King. Bottom corner, nicely done. Begovic, near post, same old story. I don't know what's wrong with him in just saving those shots, but he just can't do it for some reason. Regardless, this goal in the 55th minute, it just epitomises the way that we play. We win the ball and we break with so much pace that it doesn't matter who you are, we will score goals. And Callum Wilson does that expertly. Coming into the last 10 minutes, they get a cheeky little goal back, but it's nothing but a consolation because Jermaine Defoe, the veteran, drills in this goal, 5-2. Alright, so moving forward, we had a home game against Man City, the Premier League champions. And in the first 6 minutes, you know who's there, Josh King, doing what he does best, getting in that finish. A couple minutes later, how about this for composure? Edge of the box, places it in. I mean, that is just a beautiful looking goal. Everything about that is just absolutely great. 2-0 up in 20 minutes, we're in dreamland. Now, I'm not going to lie, I felt like City were there for the taking on the counter. We were all over him. Jordan Ibe doing what he's been doing all season, breaking down the wing, chopping back on inside, and then how about that for a finish? Technical seal from Loftus-Cheek, just paying back some of that 14 mil we spent on him. Keeper was no chance. Going in the second half, I mean, we were all over him. Josh King picking up a hat-trick. City were absolutely nowhere near coming back, and then they scored an overhead kick. Bit disappointing to concede that goal. And then defensive mistake in the last minute, they pick up another one. But it didn't mean anything because we had just beaten the champions 4-2. In absolute dreamland, we can beat the best teams in the country. It's all thanks to this man here. He's been carrying us the season. All of the goals pretty much coming from him and Callum Wilson. Right, so looking at the other competitions, FA Cup, won't really talk about it too much. I mean, we drew with Leeds and then we lost to replay. Disappointing, but we were focusing purely on the league. Carabao Cup, yeah, I mean, losing on penalties to Bristol City, it's not ideal. But next season, we'll be back, we'll be better than that. Looking at the league table, you can see that we were level on points with Man United. We were so close to getting in the top four. 6 games to go, but we still had to play Spurs. That was going to be important. I think we're going to wrap the video up there as well. And in the next one, we'll go over the next 6 games just to see if we can actually make it into the top four. We're so close to getting European football. So, hope you enjoyed it. If you did, leave the video a like and subscribe. And I'll see you in the next one.